Hi guys from BJJ Library, it's a great pleasure to have you here. One of the, in my opinion, one of the most unorthodox games in the sport, and also a friend of the family, and also one of the toughest guys I've ever fought in my life, and also an incredible instructor. We're here with Telles. It's my great pleasure to have you here, my brother. Learn some third regard that if anybody has any doubt, yeah, it really works. It's been tested and proved over the years. And one more time, proving the essence of jiu-jitsu, that's the fingerprint. And Telles' fingerprint is unique, his approach, and how he see life, and how he see his game in jiu-jitsu that works for him in gi, no gi, and different levels. And we are very honored to have him here to tell something about himself and about his background. So my brother, how do you start in jiu-jitsu? Oh, who was the guy responsible?
All right. And, yeah, thank you very much for the compliments. It's an honor to be here, you know, and showing a little bit of myself, you know, and thank you for the opportunity. And yeah, I started jiu-jitsu, you know, I always been in love with martial arts. I was a karate guy before, you know.
I saw how you kicked Sapo in the head, knocked him out.
I was a karate guy. I saw the Van Damme movies, you know. Yeah, so that's one of the reasons that I start training karate, and then they start teaching jiu-jitsu in the same gym. I'm from São Paulo. You know, jiu-jitsu was big in Rio in that time. My father was from Rio, and I used to travel a lot to Rio in weekends, and people say, oh, the Gracie family, you know, it's tough, oh, beating everyone. And I was a karate guy. I say, oh my God, no way, I'm karate.
Which year was that?
You know, like long time ago. I can't remember, like, and then I was, you know, like, I have some friends from Rio. I say, no, I'm karate. And then I saw, you know, I used to boogie board in that time, and I went to Hawaii, and I saw the tape in like the first UFC, and I say, oh my God, you know, jiu-jitsu really, really works. And then they start teaching jiu-jitsu in the same gym as I used to do karate, and I switch, you know, right away to, I started doing jiu-jitsu, and I fall in love. It was much more relaxed, you know. Karate was too much like discipline. You couldn't talk during the class, you know. Jiu-jitsu was more, you know, like laid back. People can, you know, like talk, spar, you know, submit people.
Who was your first instructor?
In jiu-jitsu, Yamazaki. Fernando Yamazaki. Okay. He was a judo guy also, so I have some judo base, not too much, but I know some. That's why I start first doing more top game, and then later I decide to really, after purple belt, I decide, no, I gotta learn open guard.
So how long until you get your blue belt?
6 months.
6 months with Yamazaki?
With Yamazaki.
And then?
I fought a tournament in White Belt. You know, my first tournament I won, so.
Yeah? So it was fun, I never won shit as a White Belt in blue belt.
I was tough, I was a really tough White Belt. Oh my God, I was wild. You know, yes, I was totally, like now I'm totally.
Telles had a long hair for the guys who don't know, you know, he had long hair.
No, it was before the long hair, yeah, it was before the long hair. Yeah, White Belt, crazy guy. Crazy White Belt, really wild. I remember submitting purple belts in the White Belt. Yeah, it was.
And that's the beauty of jiu-jitsu, because we have the stereotype that it's just this big guys, ugly, big ears, and you see this guy, humble as can be, but don't judge the book by the cover.
Yeah.
And then, blue belt, how long you stay in the blue belt?
Also, maybe a year.
That's all, 1 year?
Maybe.
In the blue belt?
Maybe a year. I was wild.
You were some damage.
Oh yeah, I was wild.
Some damage in the blue belt. People usually take for crazy, the BJJ library fans, usually take 3 years, 4 years. Some people stay forever in the blue belt. 1 year it's pretty fast.
Yeah.
And then who gave you the purple belt?
And then Carlos Valente.
Who?
Yeah, man.
Here in San Diego?
Here in San Diego. I moved to San Diego to learn English. And I stayed here for like
six,
7 months. He was teaching with Fabio Santos in the time.
Dinosaurs of Jiu-Jitsu.
Yeah, and I was training with them. And then he gave me my purple belt and I fought the Joey Mora's tournament.
Yeah, Joey Mora's tournament.
And I won.
As a purple belt.
So yeah, and then I moved back to Brazil and I started to train with Fabio Gurgel in the purple.
Oh, okay, in
and
the
then
purple
I
belt.
Stay with Fabio from purple to black.
And then you got your black belt in 2001.
And one, yeah. Me, Damian Maia.
That generation, the golden generation. Uh-huh. And then when did you decide, I'm going to be a teacher, that's what I'm going to do for a living?
Yeah, when I got the black belt, you know, I decided, you know, me and Tereré, we decided to put a gym together. You know, we were really good friends. And I used to run a sushi restaurant in that time. You know, I still have my sushi restaurant.
I mean, there, one of the best in São Paulo. You guys gotta check it out.
And then, yeah, but I'm in love with jiu-jitsu, you know, so that's my thing. And I decided, I put the gym. I'm so glad, you know, that I put the gym together with Tereré. I learned so much, you know, from him. We built a great team. And
it's called TT, huh?
Yeah.
Telles Tereré.
Yeah, it's called TT. Yeah, it was a great time. I miss that time so much.
And then the times passed by, and then what happened?
Yeah, then
keep training.
I built my own team, 99, and then I sold my old gym to Barbosa, and I moved to the States, and I'm here right now. You know, the place I always love. You know, I used to come here to San Diego since I'm 17, you know, and now I'm here for real, you know. I love the city, love the weather, love the waves, you know. The jiu-jitsu, it's huge here. That's the capital of jiu-jitsu, so I'm really happy.
And the jiu-jitsu community is happy, San Diego is happy, because having a guy, a man of family like Telles is just enrich the community of jiu-jitsu and give us one more option to get great experience through martial arts. And I think that's the goal when somebody join a martial arts environment. And I think that Telles has all the credentials on the mat and outside the mat to serve as an example and a role model in the jiu-jitsu community. Thanks, my brother. Really appreciate
thank you,
it.
Thank you.
I want to have you here. I hope I don't have to do Toroga no more because it's really a nightmare, I guarantee. Thank you, guys. BJJ Library, one more guy in the books, one more gentleman.
Thank you. Very honored, guys. Peace.